Ooh, excuse me. Hi guys. I'm drinking a can of fizzy pop, and I just went down the wrong way. Wrong way. Excuse me. Right, where were we? Hello, it's Mike, it's Wongo ShortPlay, and we are playing The Adventures of Rocky and Bullwinkle and Friends on the Sega Mega Drive. Let's see. Our story begins in beautiful downtown. I'm not reading it. I could read it. I'm not going to. Main game. We want the main game, please. Not any of these fancy sub-games. Not a moment too soon. I don't know what happened because we skipped it. We've missed it. We've missed all the story. Oh well. They appear to be in no rush. Look at them with all the calm demeanour of Sherlock Holmes and Watson wandering through the Swiss Alps. Is that where they had that battle with Moriarty? I don't know. I know nothing about geography. I'm guessing that needs to be jumped over. What is going on with that? I mean, come on. Is that... Alright, I should have done that, shouldn't I? Oh well, we live and learn. Is that really... I'm not sure that's alright. I'm not sure that's... Oh man, okay, I see. Some weird jump of physics, we are doing it. We're doing that. So we've got to dodge them and progress up. Press up on the D-pad. Press right on the D-pad. Press up on the D-pad. Press, whoa, up on the D-pad. Oh man, I was getting a bit tricky now. That was a bit full on. Oh really? Okay, so hiding doesn't necessarily protect you, but you can jump and you can throw things. I'm guessing it's the things I've picked up. These stones defy physics, Holmes. Oh, that one was particularly murderous. Oh, we're back at the... Okay, no, that's alright. We're alright with that. We can handle that. Let's not flip out. Oh, man. Alright. So, I'm guessing we're taking on the role of the eponymous Bullwinkle. With his bulls... Well, Winkle. He's not a bull, he's a... Yeah, he's a moose. He is a moose. Oh, man. Well, that kind of sucked. Was that... Oh, no, that's cool. I thought that was game over. I was actually going to have another go with this game if it had gone particularly wrong. But no, we're all right. Okay. So Rocky and Bullwinkle... I can't say Bullwinkle. Rocky and Bullwinkle seems to be some kind of a slightly alternative 2D platformer for the Mega Drive. It's not the sort of game you see a lot of on the Mega Drive. And... hasn't been a guess that I kind of know why. That's a headbutt of some sort. Cool. I'm guessing it's not particularly good, but I'm also not going to be too quick to judge it, I think, if I go over that one. Or is that just one that there's no way around? Oh well, I'm mad. Yeah, not... Not completely enthralling, I have to admit. You know what, though? Yeah. Because I think I can do better than that. I like that noise when he jumps. That's kind of cute. Yeah, you know, it kind of feels like the IP on which it's based, doesn't it? Oh, man, I don't like that mechanic at all. It seems to really enjoy pelting me with those rocks. You know, it's not... Look, it's not completely offensive. To me, gamer sensibilities. It's a little bit alternative and I like that. The whole climbing thing's kind of cool. Alright, the colour scheme is quite offensive. Downright offensive. That magenta is a bit ZX Spectrum. Unnecessarily so. And doesn't really fit with the foreground stuff. But hey, this is not a detailed analysis of the game's artwork. The question is it any good? I'm getting there, I'm getting there. See, I don't like that I can't see what's coming. That's better. Marginally better. Oh. Okay. You know, it's... Oh, that's harsh. It's structured, it's... Oh, man. It's got a set and something. Can I... Oh, you can? Awesome. Give you some of your own medicine. Oh, I see. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. I pressed that button. Hang on. No. Just no. These sentient rocks are a bit random, though. And that one doesn't seem to be avoidable. I like the way the level's got... Oh, no, that's got a crack in it. I like the way the level's got variety. Oh, no! Fall into his death. Not a nice way to go. I like the variety. I think it's... Again, it's another little charmer. I don't know how to get past that one. I'm gonna have to take the hit, I'm afraid. Okay. Really. There are some cheap hits in this game. That looks like a bunch of broken ones. It is a bunch of broken ones. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Oh, man. I mean, some of it is just unavoidable, you know? That sucked. But I quite like the way it plays. No, I'm done. That was Rocky and Bullwinkle for the Sega Mega Drive. Not the best platformer, but probably not the worst. Thanks for watching.